Hello, I'm Marc Desgroseilliers from Technical Support here at Pix4D, and today we're talking about the Mosaic Editor. So let's start by saying, what is an orthomosaic? The orthomosaic is a 2D output, so a map, which is going to be a stitch of all the images that were taken in the project, but this stitching of all the images is going to be corrected for perspective. So we're going to use the positioning of the cameras, which is information that the mapper has, to be able to correct for perspective and to create a 2D map where the distances are true, relatively speaking. In the mapper, there is the Mosaic Editor, which is going to allow you to edit and to visualize the orthomosaic. It's available after the third step of processing, and it looks something like this. So you can see the orthomosaic in the main window, and you have some options on the right to create a new region, change the content of this region, and save and export the orthomosaic. So when you create a region, there's going to be a choice where you can choose between the ortho projection and the planar projection. So let's quickly go over what is the difference between these two types of projection. As I said, when the orthomosaic is generated, it's going to take the information from the images and blend this information together, and so decide for every pixel what is the color that it should have. And this is done in a way that will, where the perspective is going to be corrected. Now, if you insert a region, you draw your region, and now you can decide in this region, what am I going to project? How am I going to assign the color to the pixels? You can, and if you choose the ortho projection, it's going to use the same algorithm that was used for the generation of the whole orthomosaic, but it's just going to use the images that were selected by the user. So let's say you choose 5 images, you say these 5 images, they were taken from an angle that was not too large, so they were more or less on top of the scene. And if I use just these images, maybe some of the artifacts that I'm seeing in the orthomosaic are going to be reduced. So I'm going to use the same algorithm, the same way to stitch the images, but just with these 5 images. And then that can improve the result for this region. The alternative is to use the planar projection. What does the planar projection do? It just, it takes the region and it's going to project the content of a single image onto this region. Now, what this means is that since this is a projection from a single image, the perspective is not going to be corrected, and therefore the distances are not going to be true. Now, why would you want to do that? Well, let me give you an example. Let's say you have a neighborhood and you have a few houses, and this is the main point of interest of your project. But there's also a forested area, let's say a park next to the neighborhood. And the main point of interest are the few houses, but you also want to include this forested area in your project. However, because of the geometry of the trees in the orthomosaic, you see some artifacts, maybe some doubling of the leaves or something like this. And you want to correct for this. But this is not the main region of interest, so maybe you don't care so much that the distances are not true. So then what you can do is you can draw a region around around these trees, and then you can do a planar projection with an image that was taken more or less above the tree. And therefore, I mean, these distances are not going to be accurate in this region, but it might create a more visually pleasing result, and this is all you care about for this particular area of the project. So this is one good example of when you would want to use the planar projection. Let's move on to a point which is a little bit tricky with the orthomosaic, which is saving the orthomosaic, because there's both an internal copy and there's the exported GeoTIFF that you can use in a third-party software. So let's see what happens. So you draw a region, and maybe you draw a few regions, and you want to save the changes that you made in Pix4Dmapper. So then you're going to click Save, and what this will do is that it will overwrite the internal copy of the orthomosaic. but it will not change the exported GeoTIFF. If you want to these changes to be repercutted on the exported GeoTIFF, then you will need to click the export button. So that's the difference between save and export, is that it will affect either the internal copy on which you're working, which is the internal copy of the inside the software. And then if you use export, it will re-export the orthomosaic, so then it will modify the exported GeoTIFF. In the Orthomosaic editor, there's also a visualization option, and this will give you some information about the pixel distribution, the distribution of the value of the pixels. And it will also allow you to analyze this information either for the whole orthomosaic or just for a single band. So let's go now inside the mapper. And let's see how you can add the region, select the images that are going to be used in the planar or ortho projection, and let's see how to do this inside the software. Here is my orthomosaic. I'm in the mosaic editor here, and let me show you how to add a region. So let's go maybe to the side of the project, where typically there are less images, less overlap, and so you can see more artifacts. So here you see I have the street and there are some blobs, and here the trees didn't get reconstructed quite okay. And let me draw a region. And I finish the region by right-clicking. Here it is. And now I can choose a planar projection, and already you can see that the orthomosaic looks much better. This is for visual reasons. So now I'm going to leave this region, and maybe I show you how to draw another one. Left click, and then right click to finish, and then I choose ortho projection. This takes a little bit longer because the mapper has to produce the ortho projection. But let's say I pick these three images. See, these three images are... And now the orthomosaic is generated using only these three images. And if I delete it, we see a slight difference. So that's how you can edit the orthomosaic after generation in order to improve its visual aspect. I hope this video has been helpful, and I'll see you in the next video.